top 10 private bee schools in India.
Our focus is on cutting edge domain knowledge and benchmarking with world-class businesses.
BinTech, excellence with values.
But what that taught me was that I think India, if India has to be reformed, if India has to give a billion people their aspirations to get a better life, the only way is to use technology judiciously and use technology for empowerment. And that was what was the vision that drove us to build the Aadhaar platform. But it was not just that we built the Aadhaar platform of giving an ID to everyone. On top of that, we built the world's largest cash transfer system, and that's called as the Aadhaar payment bridge, where people can get their government benefits directly into the bank account using the Aadhaar number. And today India does a billion transactions a year. The run rate today is about a billion transactions a year. And all the LPG subsidies, pensions, scholarships, kerosene subsidies, everything is now going through the Aadhaar payment bridge. So this is actually a very, very major reform, because historically we used to subsidize products. Now the difference is that people will buy products at market price and get the difference into their bank accounts. So this leads to literally, you know, millions and billions of transactions. And this also eliminates wastage, because it removes ghosts, removes duplicates, and makes sure that the benefit reaches the right person. So the direct cash transfer is also part of what is done. And then we also built, as part of this whole thing, the ability for people to use their Aadhaar number to withdraw money in a village using a small phone kind of a device. And this is basically using Aadhaar's authentication capability, where you can put your finger or your eye and you can authenticate and get money out from a grocery store. Why I'm telling you all this is because you know, we are talking about going cashless, so I thought you should know that some of these things are already here, and I'll talk about it later with Nalin on the conversation. So that was again a very important thing. And then we built something called eKYC, which allows you to electronically open a bank account, get a SIM card, get an insurance policy, or get a mutual fund or a pension. And today, if you look at Reliance Jio, they have sold more than 40-50 million SIM cards using the Aadhaar eKYC, which allows you to get the phone connection in about 5 minutes. And similarly, the new banks that are coming up, the Airtel Payments Bank, which got launched this week, is using Aadhaar eKYC to open bank accounts. So fundamentally, the infrastructure that we created is seeping into the system, and it's really becoming an integral part of everything that we do. When I was in the government, I was also entrusted by Mr. Pranab Mukherjee, at that time the finance minister, to design the backbone of the GST. And I had a committee which designed the GST, processed all the invoices of the GST system, which is going to go live perhaps next year. This again is a major leapfrog, because every business in India, and which is going to file taxes, all these are, which I described in the book, which Viral and I have talked about. One more system which we did was designing the electronic tolling system for Indian highways. And the government set up a company called the Indian National Highway Management Company Limited, which actually is now going to operate that. And essentially every vehicle, whether it's a bus or a truck or a car, we'll have politics, so I don't make political judgments anymore. The important thing is that the fact that we have had this sort of a shock given to the system, in my view, will help in accelerating the digitization of the financial economy. So my wife Rohini says I always see everything as an optimist, so I guess I'm an optimist here also. And I know that it's causing tremendous pain to people and so on. And that pain is going to be there for some more time. But fundamentally, I think when you have shaken the trust of people in physical currency, I think they will be ready for something else which works, much more so than earlier before. And I think that is going to happen. I also think that when we sort of designed the architecture for making India's economy digital finance economy, we thought this was something that will take about 3 years. Within that 3 years, we'll reduce to 3 months. So in some sense, the requirement to rapidly make India digital will get accelerated to a 3 to 6 month time frame, and not a 3 year time frame. Now the question comes up, what do you need to do? That's the heart of it, right? So I think we are very fortunate because a lot of the pieces are already in place. For example, thanks to Aadhaar and the Aadhaar payment bridge, more and more government benefits are flowing into bank accounts. That is cashless. Money leaves the LPG company IOC and comes into your bank account when you buy a cylinder. That is a cashless transaction which is going electronically into your bank account. And today we have about 350 million bank accounts linked to Aadhaar numbers. That will grow in the next few months to 400 to 450 million. So for governments putting money into people's bank accounts, that will be cashless. Second is that increasingly remittances by urban Indians to rural Indians, that has already become cashless. Because NPCI built a very good system called the Immediate Payment System, IMPS, which does about 29,000 crores of transactions per month.